What to expect before surgery. UHN is one of the top centers for endocrine surgery, including thyroid, parathyroid, and adrenal tumor surgery. In this video, you will learn how to prepare for your first appointment with your surgeon, for the possible risks of thyroid and parathyroid surgery, and how to prepare for your pre-surgery anesthesia appointment. How to prepare for your appointment with your surgeon. Before your appointment is booked, your referring doctor will be asked to send the results of your important tests to the surgical office. These include your laboratory results, imaging, and biopsy reports. If you have had an ultrasound, CT, or MRI done outside of UHN, please bring a copy of these images with you to your appointment. You can get this CD from the hospital where your ultrasound, MRI, or CT scan was done. Once your reports and previous tests have been reviewed, you will be given your first appointment or consultation to meet with one of the endocrine surgeons. If you are able, mail the CD or bring it to the office before your consultation. These images will be reviewed by your surgeon and will speed up your care. Possible risks of endocrine surgery. Although thyroid and parathyroid surgery is very safe, there are three main risks with this type of surgery. These are called recurrent laryngeal nerve injury, also called RLN injury, risk of injury or removal of the parathyroid glands, and neck bleeding. Recurrent laryngeal nerve injury. The nerves that move your vocal cords to produce the sound of your voice are found behind the thyroid gland on both sides of the neck. If either of these nerves are injured, for example during surgery, your voice may become hoarse and weak.
If both nerves are injured during surgery, you may need a tracheostomy to help you breathe.
For every 100 thyroid or parathyroid surgeries, about one person will have problems with their vocal cords in the long term. Some people will have changes to their voice even if their vocal cord nerves are not injured during surgery. These changes may be in the volume and the tone of their voice. Your vocal cords will be checked before and after your surgery. Professional voice users and singers are most affected. If you sing for your job or use your voice for professional reasons, please tell your surgeon. Risk of removal or injury to your parathyroid glands. If you're having thyroid surgery, there is a risk of removal or injury to your parathyroid glands. This may happen because the thyroid and parathyroid glands are close together. If your parathyroid glands are injured or removed during surgery, this may cause the calcium levels in your blood to drop. If you develop any signs or symptoms of low calcium levels, you may need to take extra calcium. Symptoms of low calcium include numbness or tingling in the fingers or around the mouth or toes. If you have ongoing symptoms after taking the calcium supplements, please talk to your doctor or nurse. Some patients need to take calcium supplements after surgery to increase the calcium level in the blood. Neck bleeding. Out of every 200 surgeries, one person may have neck bleeding, which may cause pressure on your airway. If this happens, you may need an extra surgery to stop the bleeding. Other risks of thyroid and parathyroid surgery include possible neck infection. Talk to your doctor if you have questions about neck bleeding and neck infections. For parathyroid surgeries, 5 out of 100 people may continue to have problems with their parathyroids after surgery.
Parathyroid glands may not be found during surgery, or new parathyroid tumors may cause problems after surgery.
If this happens, you may need more tests and possible other interventions. How to prepare for your pre-surgery anesthesia appointment. Before your surgery, you will be given a general anesthetic. A general anesthetic is medicine that puts you to sleep so you don't feel pain during surgery. You will speak to the pre-surgery clinic staff before your surgery to discuss your anesthetic plan. Your appointment may take place over the phone or in person. This will depend on any other medical issues that you have and which surgery you are having. Do not take blood thinners for at least 5 to 7 days before your surgery. This may increase your risk of bleeding. If you take aspirin, 81 milligrams every day, you may continue to take it if needed. Talk to the preoperative clinic if you take blood thinners. You have come to the end of this video on what to expect before you have endocrine surgery. In this video, you have learned how to prepare for your appointment with your surgeon, the possible risks of endocrine surgery, and how to prepare for your pre-surgery anesthesia appointment. Please watch the next video to know what to expect the day of your surgery.